So far, we've discussed a little bit about how to model assets in AF. We've seen how to build an element based on an asset and then add the attributes to that element to collect the data for that particular asset. So far, we have one of our zones set up with five different attributes. Now, we know that our building has three zones, so we're also going to want elements for those as well. And we'd like them to be consistent with zone one, so that we can compare similar data across them. That's where probably the most powerful feature of AF comes into play, and that's being able to build templates. So we can use this zone one element that we've built as a basis for our zone template, and then we can take that template and use it to easily build zone two and zone three elements. And then they're going to have this exact same set of attributes. One of the nice thing about templates is that if we have a bunch of different elements, say our zone 1, 2, and 3 elements we'll eventually have here, all built off the same zone template, if we decide we need to add another calculation attribute or some new data source we become aware of, we can easily add that at the template level, and then that change will get pushed out to all of the zone elements that are based on that template. So it can be a real time saver when you decide you want to update your model. It also makes things consistent. So you don't have a bunch of different elements that look different from each other, and therefore it makes it really difficult to try and look at the data across all those elements. So another nice thing about this AF structure and templatization is that we have AF functionality built into all of our client tools. So if you've taken any of our client courses in the last few years, you probably remember hearing something about an element relative display in process book. So if we started with something like this that we looked at earlier, where it's like a monitoring display for our zone temperature, we have that here, and then we have our, that's the set point, and then we have our zone temperature, and then we were also looking at our offset. So if we wanted to take this and reuse the same display for all of our zones, we could do that. I'll just cheat a little bit. I have a pre-configured HVAC database that already has all three zones set up, so I'll take advantage of that, and we'll see how we could quickly turn this single zone display into an element relative display that lets us look at data for all three zones. First, I'll just save this, call it zones. We'll call it zones temp diff ERD. And now I'm going to go in here and just convert our symbols to use element relative. First, I'm going to shrink these down a little bit because I know that our element selection pane will take up a little bit of space. So first, I'll go to view and get the element relative display pane in here. Widen that out so we can get to the AF search. And I'll get to the right AF production database, HVAC production. The search route, I'll start at the lab level. And in this database, I've already got a zone template set up. So I'll look for any elements based on that zone template. Go ahead and do my search. And there's my three zones. I'll just grab all those. And now we can start converting our symbols. So I'll start first with this trend. And we'll go to our element relative menu. You can see I have my zone here, and here's all my set of attributes for that zone. So we wanted the thermostat setting and the temperature. And this is another nice thing about AF integration to the clients. We can get automated unit conversion for our client tools. That should be okay. And now you see we have our temperature and our thermostat setting. Looks like I didn't move these quite far enough over. There we go. And I'll convert this value symbol that's tracking our temperature offset. Get our temperature offset here. Again, I'll select some units for it. Click OK. And now we can use this elements of interest pane to select our element. And you see that the data updates automatically. So By having its own template, we were able to easily convert this single zone display to a display that allows us to see data for all three of our zones. And we'll see as we continue to build templates and expand our hierarchy, it'll become much easier to find and manipulate data in the Pi client tools. So next we'll switch back over to our AF server and discuss templates further. So we'll return back to our HVAC example database that we've been building. And just as a quick refresher, remember that we have a zone 1 element, and we've defined a set of attributes for it using our various data references. And for now, we decided that's a good set of data to be able to define our zones, and we'd like to have the same information for zone 2 and zone 3 that we have for zone 1. Remember, this AF is very flexible, and you can always expand these models later and add new attributes. So it's fine if we want to go ahead and proceed now and build out our other zone elements. Now, obviously, I'm endorsing the use of templates, and hopefully I'll convince you that that's the best way to proceed, but just for the sake of argument, let's look at a couple of different ways that one might think of to start expanding our database to the other zones. So one approach might be to just simply proceed the same way with zone 2 that we did with zone 3. We'll add a new element, call it zone 2, and we can start adding in attributes, and then we have to switch back to zone 1 and make sure that these attribute names make their way into the zone 2 element, that the names match each other, and then we have to redefine all the configuration strings. And I think you can see where I'm going here, that this is just not a very efficient way of expanding the model. So let's not pursue it any further. We'll look at another method that might be used. So I'll use our handy undo the checkout button. And we'll get rid of those changes. So another approach might be to make a copy of zone 1. And just paste it back into the elements collection. And it's pretty smart. It just increments through the numbers as we paste new elements. So we've already got zone 2 here. And we can see, because we did some smart stuff with our data references, that this zone number, based on the string builder data reference, gets the 2 from the element name. And of course, our table lookup takes that 2 and looks up a proper area for us. And we have our temperature offset formula reference already defined as the difference between these two tags. So really the only work left would be to go into these two PiPoint data references and go find the correct tag for zone 2. Now that seems pretty easy. We still run into an issue that because these two zones aren't based on the same template, in fact they're based on no template at all, our client tools really have no way of knowing that they're related assets. Another disadvantage is that any user with write access to the elements could come in and, you know, just add a new attribute here. Let's call it random value, and then, you know, another user could come in and add an attribute here. Another random value. And now we start getting mismatches between our zones. So another nice thing about templates is it's going to enforce this uniformity across all the related assets. And that becomes very important as an organizational tool when we want to find data in the system. So hopefully I've convinced you that these two approaches so far are inferior, and you can proceed with templates.